Hello students, so today our second class of computer, lesson 1. So this is lesson number system. In the last class we have discussed about the different types of the number system, whether decimal number system, binary number system, octal number system, hexadecimal number system, okay, in our first video. And this also in the last class we have discussed about that the base number of every number system, the base number of decimal number system is what? 10. This means that we are using 10 different digits, 10 different symbols to represent any number. Like example, we want 29. So we have used 3 digits here, 1, 2, and 9. So whatever the allowable digits in the decimal number system? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So these are the 10 different digits which we use in the decimal number system. So in the arithmetics, in the maths, what you are studying, that is the decimal number system. Now, octal number system. Octal number system, the base is 8, means we are using only 8 different digits. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. These are the 8 allowable digits in the octal number system. So any number you written, suppose we written 347. So this 347 is not same as 347 in decimal number system. Understand? 347 in decimal number system is not equal to 347 in octal number system. Both are not same. Both have the different values. Here this number has a different value. This will indicate any other decimal number. No. 347 in the octal is not equal to 347 in the decimal. Okay. So if you translate, if we convert this octal number to the decimal number, we are not going to get the same number. Okay. That will get a different number. So this will, in this lesson, we will learn that how we convert octal into decimal and decimal into octal, how we convert octal into binary. All this we will learn in this lesson. Next is the binary number system. See, in the binary, we are using only two different digits, two different symbols, 0 and 1. In the binary, the base of the binary is 2, means allowable digits is what? 0 and 1. With the help of 0 and 1, you have to represent any number. So in the binary, how you write 6? 1, 1, 0. In the binary, we are writing 6 as 1, 1, 0. Next is the hexadecimal number system, base 16, means we use 16 different symbols digits. 10 will be what? 0 to 9. 0 to 9 you can use. And A to F. A to F. So this is 10 and plus 6 is 10. So any number you have to write in the hexadecimal number system, you can write as like F16. Python playing F16. Python playing. So that is the hexadecimal number system. Okay, so these are the different number system. Now today we will learn that how we convert a decimal into binary number system. How we convert a decimal number into binary. Decimal to binary conversion we will learn today. Now see, how we convert the decimal number system into binary number system. So conversion of decimal into binary. Conversion of decimal into binary. Conversion of decimal into binary. See, one decimal number we are taking. Suppose you have taken 112, which is the decimal number, and we want to convert into the binary base 2. So see what we do. Divide the decimal number with the given base in which you want to change it. So we want to convert the decimal into binary. So we divide the decimal number by the base of the binary. Base of the binary is 2. So see, here we do the division. write its remainder also in front of it. So we divide and write the remainders. Okay. So first, 2 5s are 10, 2 6s are 12. Remainder 0. So remainder we write. Again divide 56 by 2. 2 28s are 56. Remainder 0. Next, 2 14s are 28. Remainder 0. So here we are writing the remainder. This is a remainder. What we are writing? This is remainder. This section got remainder I am writing. So divide 14 by 2. 2 7s are 14. Remainder 0. Divide 7 by 2. 2 3s are 6. Remainder 1. This time remainder 1. This time remainder 1. Now divide 2 1s are 2. Remainder 1. Okay. Now again when you divide, so from here to here, again you divide 2 0s are 0. Remainder 1. So from 0 0 0 0. Okay, and the bottom is the most significant bit, MSB. MSB means most significant bit. You can write MSB as most significant bit. We can take another example, then it will be clear to you all. Here in the book, taken 25, that we are going to take, 25. One, zero, zero, one. 1. It's a binary equivalent. 1, 1, 0, 0, 1 is the binary equivalent of decimal number 25. Okay, like this we have to do. So now, what are the steps? First of all, we have to divide the given decimal number with the base 2. And after that, cut down the remainder and divide the quotient again by 2. We write down the quotient and divide the quotient again by 2. So here, in every division, we have to write the quotient and remainder. This is the quotient and this is the remainder. 2, 12 and 24, 12 is the quotient, 1 is the remainder. Okay? Again, 2, 6 and 12, 6 is the quotient, 0 is the remainder. So what? Second, third, repeat the step 2 till the quotient 0. So we have to repeat this division process till the quotient I am getting 0. And write the remainders obtained in each step in the reverse order to form the binary equivalent of the given decimal number. Means missing the least significant digit at the end, at the top, and the most significant digit at the bottom. So the most significant digit will get at the bottom, this is the least significant digit. So at the beginning, starting in front, the most significant, this is the least significant. So this is the least significant digit. This is called the LSD or LSB both. Least significant bit, LSD. And this is MSB, most significant bit. Place value is high. Okay. So this is all for the today, students. In the next class, we will study that how to convert the binary number to decimal number. Binary number to decimal number. So this is all for today. Thank you for your kind attention.